Hi everyone, I'm Robert Moody. I'm the music director of Arizona Music Fest, and this is the time of the year that we should all be gathering together in Scottsdale, Arizona, one of the greatest orchestras, festival orchestras anywhere in the world that I have the great privilege and honor to conduct, making some of the most amazing live music really heard anywhere. Unfortunately, because of the pandemic, we cannot do that this year. So we thought that we would give you some fantastic memories from last year's full orchestra festival. We are not going to be without live music in the coming months. There's a great outdoor festival that we have with Arizona Music Fest, and the orchestra will be part of that. On May the 1st, we're doing two performances outside at Pinnacle Presbyterian Church of some really fantastic music of Copland, Elgar, and Beethoven. But it's a small group, and it's nothing like the 85 or so piece orchestra playing some of the most majestic music. It's really what keeps me going, what keeps my heart beating, I think, to have these live music experiences. So since we can't do that right now, we're going to give you some of the really highlights of last year's festival. Hopefully this will whet your appetite for just that time when we're finished with COVID and we can be back together. I've chosen five excerpts, if you will. I've gone through all of the recordings from last year's festival, and it was difficult, but I picked five of my favorite moments. One of them came on a concert in which we featured all Spanish and Latin influenced music. And one of the great pieces on that concert was music from the ballet, The Three-Cornered Hat by composer Manuel de Falla. This piece is right at 100 years old. It premiered in 1919, and it was a fiery ballet that combined great traditional ballet dancing with Spanish dancing. The end, the jota, is one of the most fantastic whirlwinds of music I think I've ever conducted for orchestra. So enjoy this. This is the Arizona Music Fest Festival Orchestra, the jota, the finale from Manuel de Falla's The Three-Cornered Hat.
Thank you.
My second choice for a work from last year's festival just shows the fantastic versatility of this orchestra and that we really do strive to program music from Bach to rock, from Bach, from Beethoven, Tchaikovsky, to great popular music. The music we're going to play for you next comes not from 100 years ago, but from 40 years ago. It was 1981 when the film Raiders of the Lost Ark swept the world. Score, of course, by the legendary composer John Williams. It's so difficult to pick a favorite work by John Williams, and we featured an entire concert dedicated to John Williams last season. But this Raiders March from Raiders of Lost Ark is maybe one of the very best orchestrated works he ever put together. So, quite different from the three-cornered hat. Enjoy now Raiders March from Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to take quite a jump in time for this third video that I hope you enjoy. Instead of works from the 20th century, we're moving back to the 16th century, the time when Shakespeare was in England and Elizabeth I was on the throne, and in Italy, in Venice, at St. Mark's Cathedral, the cathedral composer was Giovanni Gabrieli. He wrote some really fantastic choral music and also choral music for choruses of instruments. In this case, you're going to hear a work written in that way for brass. Now, I have to say, you would have to search the world far and wide to find a brass ensemble better than the brass section at Arizona Music Fest. Really, it's true of all of our sections of the orchestra, but I really think you're going to enjoy this. And you will see they are placed in two opposing groups, really on either side of the hall, of the concert hall, from each other. The idea is that this music was to be played in an antiphonal style. Antiphonal, it's sort of like a musical tennis match. Listen, and you'll see what I mean. Here's Giovanni Gabrieli's Canzone Settimi Toni. For this fourth video, this penultimate video of our set of five, we are moving back closer at least towards current time. We're coming to the end of the 19th century, 1899 to be exact, when one of perhaps the greatest English composer of all time, Edward Elgar, wrote his Enigma Variations. The Enigma Variation, such a powerful work, so-called Enigma because, well, he sort of kept us guessing when he wrote the work. He wrote a theme, an original theme, and 14 variations. And for those variations on the score, he just gave clues as to what each variation might represent. Most of the time, the clues were simply initials. Eventually, he revealed that these initials represented his close friends, colleagues, students, family members, even one friend's dog. And each variation is set to be sort of a loving nod to that person. My favorite, and I would dare say the favorite of probably most of the world, is the ninth variation. It was called Nimrod, and Nimrod was a little bit of a clue to represent a friend of his who had a Germanic last name close to the word hunter, as in Nimrod the hunter. And it depicts a time when Elgar and his friend were walking through the woods, and Elgar was somewhat despondent about his role as a creative person making music, and it was his friend who really just gave him a resurgence of energy and confidence in his work. What came from that is one of the most famous themes of all time. There are some themes where it seems to me the theme almost comes from God. The theme of Barbara Adagio for strings, of Jupiter from the Planets by Gustav Holst come to mind. This Nimrod is one of those themes, and it has a power to move the listener, but really to move the soul. I think this happened very clearly on our concert last year with the Arizona Music Fest. Here's Nimrod from Elgar's Enigma Variations. Well, we are at number 5 of our 5 excerpts of great videos from the February 2020 Arizona Musicfest Orchestra Festival Week. This is the final one. I guess I could say we tried to save the best for last. They're all so great. We certainly saved the most grandiose for last. This comes from the late 19th century as well. It was composed in 1876 by Modest Mussorgsky, one of the mighty Russian Five. This was a group of 5 very prominent composers in Russia at the time, included names like Rimsky-Korsakov. And Mussorgsky was mostly a pianist. In fact, he usually had other people orchestrate his works for him. At this time, a close friend and colleague of his, Victor Hartmann, a well-known artist, had passed away at a young age. And Mussorgsky wrote a piano work called Pictures at an Exhibition. And the idea is sort of an imagined walk through a grand art gallery and taking in various works of Victor Hartmann. To have a grand promenade, you have to have music to accompany it. So the most familiar music is the promenade. And then each movement, if you will, is a depiction of a different painting, finishing with the Great Gate at Kiev. The Great Gate at Kiev was a sketch that Hartmann made for a great gate to be built in Kiev. It was never built, but the idea is one that would be like the Arc de Triomphe in Paris or the Brandenburg Gate in Berlin. This sense of grandeur, of course, you had to have the kind of music to match that grandeur. And Mussorgsky, orchestrated by the French composer Maurice Ravel, does just that in maybe the most ennobling, grand way of any piece of music ever written. There's no better way to finish this time together. I'll say this before you hear the piece. I was looking back through the music and thinking, wow, we pulled out all the stops in 2020. John Williams' Salute and the Pictures at an Exhibition and Enigma Variations and so much great work. How can we top that? You might be thinking, well, check out when you can the music we will be playing and offering for February of 2022. I think we are going to do just that. Keep your eye out on our website, azmusicfest.org. Check our Facebook and all of our other social media. And we can't wait to really open up the full calendar again once the pandemic is over and have us all back together with great live music and some great live music, really fantastic live music coming up this spring as well. A number of wonderful concerts at either Highland Church or Pinnacle Presbyterian Church in North Scottsdale. And I will tell you that we've made every possible effort to make absolutely sure that these are completely safe for performers and audience alike and amazingly enjoyable events. So hope to see you at those concerts and definitely hope to see you when we're back in full festival mode next season. We finish now. Thanks for taking this tour of some of the great moments of the Arizona Music Fest Festival Orchestra. And we finish with Mussorgsky's Great Gate at Kiev from Pictures at an Exhibition.